weekend till September. It raises every half hour for pleasure boats. You can't come through whenever you want. You stand by, and all the boaters pretty much know that, and the marinas tell them that. Commercial traffic can come through anytime.
So even if your boat is low enough to get under there, you can't go through?
Oh, yeah, if you don't have to draw. Yeah, I'm sorry. Just if you need the boat, the draw raised. When the boat was working, I forgot to point it out. For a good share of its life, it had the typical lifeboat that you like to look for. And it hung over. First, there were two of them, then they got rid of one. And Bob said for a while, when it was under the rowing fleet, they had one. But they were being unloaded by a crane. Somehow or another, the crane boom hit the lifeboat, get a number on it, so they trashed it and put this 13-man life raft in it. I wouldn't want to ride from here across the channel on it, let alone Lake Superior. But they also, by that time, had inflatables. And nowadays, if you watch the Lakers, they got the old one. See the old vintage one out here.
Oh, there's four.
Capsules where if they got time, everybody bailed in and down they go. But Bob said, fortunately, they never had a mishap on the Purvis. The rowing fleet did have mishaps and lost some of their crew over the years. The Purvis survived. The only other parting comment, when we go down around, you can see three lanterns or lights on the aft mast here. The Coast Guard has what they call their navigation rules that all the lake people know, but a lot of the boaters probably don't. And the rule says that if you're pulling a barge at night, you need either one amber light, second one up, or if you're pulling two barges, which you don't typically need,
I can go for a
two amber light. And the barge that's being pulled has to display that. Daytime, and like I say, every tour, like the museum, we don't have one, but the rules require
to make
daytime,
that go up.
A large black pipe.
There's so much.
If you know the rules and you see that, you know something's up. Again, Woody Bob says, you think if you saw a boat going this way, one right behind it, straight behind going the same way, no distance changing, they'd think there might be something buried in the water there. But don't tell them. And as you also could guess, that 2-inch cable hung out for about 20, 30 feet from the stern of the tug, was all the way underwater till about 20, 30 feet from the pole, and then you could see it. In between, you wouldn't know it was there. And it wasn't, it was, you know, a foot or two.
That boat's gonna make that bridge go up. That's not a sailboat, that's a yacht, but it's gonna make that, it's a mega yacht. Make that one go up.
Fortunately, it never happened. So, with that said, any questions, any thoughts? Where's the young man? Would you like to work on a tugboat?
Maybe.
That had to be quite a life. I had two friends work for Rowan and half a dozen that sailed the lakes over the years. Well, with that then, we're going to head down. You can just go ahead and open the gate here. Just come down this way, folks. This was the stairwell we're going down now was added for the tour to use as well. It's not on the boat, we didn't use it.
Put your stuff.
I don't know.
These people go ahead.
If you need that, you can get right to the point.